Assuming you have set user permissions for your blog, it's a really good idea to set specific permissions on individual lists and libraries that are part of the blog. It makes sense, for example, that you might want only certain users to be able to publish posts, or you might want to restrict the creation of post categories to the blog administrator. Here we are on the blog homepage. Click Settings and then click Site Contents. Now the first thing we need to do is allow for unique permissions by breaking the default permissions inheritance from the blog's parent site. Click the post icon, and then, once we get to the list, we'll need to go into List Settings to manage permissions for the list. So here on the Settings page, we'll click Permissions for this list, and then click the Stop Inheriting Permissions from the Parent Site command on the ribbon. Now, posts can have unique permissions from the rest of the site. You can assign a specific group the permissions necessary to approve posts, for example, or you can give one or more individuals these permissions. You do this by clicking Grant Permissions, and then clicking Show Options on the Share dialog. Now, in this case, Edward is the blog administrator, so he should be the only one that can approve comments as they come in.